blessed are you, Sovereign God, Creator of all. To you be praise and glory forever. You founded the earth in the beginning, and the heavens are the work of your hands. In the fullness of time you made us in your image, and in these last days you have spoken to us in your Son, Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh. As we rejoice in the gift of your presence among us, let the light of your love always shine in our hearts, your Spirit ever renew our lives, and your praises ever be on our lips. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. The night has passed and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. Rejoice in the gift of this new day. So may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you now and forever. Amen. Psalms 56 and 57. Have mercy on me, O God, for they trample over me. All day long they assault and oppress me. My adversaries trample over me all the day long. Many are they that make proud war against me. In the day of my fear I put my trust in you. In God, whose word I praise, in God I trust and will not fear. For what can flesh do to me? All day long they wound me with words. Their every thought is to do me evil. They stir up trouble, they lie in wait. Marking my steps, they seek my life. Shall they escape for all their wickedness? In anger, O God, cast the peoples down. You have counted up my groaning, put my tears into your bottle. Are they not written in your book? Then shall my enemies turn back on the day when I call upon them. This I know, for God is on my side. In God whose word I praise, in the Lord whose word I praise, God, I trust and will not fear. What can flesh do to me? To you, O God, will I fulfill my vows. To you will I present my offering of thanks, for you will deliver my soul from death and my feet from falling, that I may walk before God in the light of the living. Be merciful to me, O God, be merciful. For my soul takes refuge in you. In the shadow of your wings will I take refuge. Until the storm of destruction has passed by, I will call upon the Most High God, the God who fulfills his purpose for me. He will send from heaven and save me, and rebuke those that would trample upon me. God will send forth his love and his faithfulness. I lie in the midst of life. People whose teeth are spears and arrows, and their tongue a sharp sword. Be exalted, O God, above the heavens, and your glory over all the earth. They have laid a net for my feet, my soul is pressed down. They have dug a pit before me, and will not fall into it themselves. My heart is ready, O God, my heart is ready. I will sing and give you praise. Awake, my soul, awake, harp and lyre. That I may awaken the dawn, I will give you thanks, O Lord, among the peoples. I will sing praise to you among the nations, for your loving kindness is as high as the heavens, and your faithfulness reaches to the clouds. Be exalted, O God, above the heavens, and your glory over all the earth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. First Book of Kings, chapter 18, beginning at the first verse. After many days, the word of the Lord came to Elijah in the third year of the drought, saying, Go, present yourself to Ahab. I will send rain on the earth. So Elijah went to present himself to Ahab. The famine was severe in Samaria. Ahab summoned Obadiah, who was in charge of the palace. Now Obadiah revered the Lord greatly. When Jezebel was killing off the prophets of the Lord, Obadiah took 100 prophets, hid them 50 to a cave, and provided them with bread and water. Then Ahab said to Obadiah, "Go through the land to all the springs of water and to all the waters. Perhaps we may find grass to keep the horses and mules alive and not lose some of the animals." So they divided the land between them to pass through it. Ahab went in one direction by himself, and Obadiah went in another direction by himself. As Obadiah was on the way, Elijah met him. Obadiah recognized him, fell on his face and said, "Is it you, my lord Elijah?" He answered him, "It is I. Go, tell your lord that Elijah is here." And he said, "How have I sinned that you would hand your servant over to Ahab to kill me? As the Lord your God lives, there is no nation or kingdom to which my lord has not sent to seek you. And when they would say, 'He is not here,' he would require an oath of the kingdom or nation that they had not found you. But now you say, 'Go, tell your lord that Elijah is here.' As soon as I have gone from you, the spirit of the Lord will carry you I know not where. So when I come and tell Ahab that he cannot find you, he will kill me. Although I am your servant, although I your servant, have revered the Lord from my youth. Has it not been told, my lord, what I did when Jezebel killed the prophets of the Lord? How I hid 100 of the Lord's prophets, 50 to a cave, and provided them with bread and water. Yet now you say, 'Go, tell your lord that Elijah is here.' He will surely kill me." Elijah said, "As the Lord of hosts lives, before whom I stand, I will surely show myself to him today." So Obadiah went to meet Ahab and told him, and Ahab went to meet Elijah. When Ahab saw Elijah, Ahab said to him, "Is it you, you troubler of Israel?" He answered, "I have not troubled Israel, but you have, and your father's house, because you have forsaken the commandments of the Lord and followed the Baals. Now therefore, have all Israel assemble for me at Mount Carmel, with the 450 prophets of Baal and 400 prophets of Asherah, who eat at Jezebel's table." So Ahab sent to all the Israelites and assembled the prophets at Mount Carmel. "I have given you as a light to the nations, and I have called you in righteousness. Thus says God, who created the heavens, who fashioned the earth and all that dwells on it, who gives breath to the people upon it, and spirit to those who walk in it. I am the Lord, and I have called you in righteousness. I have taken you by the hand and kept you. I have given you as a covenant to the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out the captives from the dungeon, from the prison those who sit in darkness. I am the Lord, that is my name. My glory I give to no other. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. I have given you as a light to the nations, and I have called you in righteousness." Acts of the Apostles, chapter 20, beginning at the 17th verse. From Miletus, he sent a message to Ephesus, asking the elders of the church to meet him. When they came to him, he said to them, "You yourselves know how I lived among you the entire time, from the first day that I set foot in Asia, serving the Lord with all humility and with tears, enduring the trials that came to me through the plots of the Jews. I did not shrink from doing anything helpful, proclaiming the message to you and teaching you publicly and from house to house, as I testified to both Jews and Greeks about the repentance towards God and faith towards our Lord Jesus. And now, as a captive to the Spirit, I am on my way to Jerusalem, not knowing what will happen to me there, except that the Holy Spirit testifies to me in every city that imprisonment and persecutions are waiting for me. But I do not count my life of any value to myself, if only I may finish my course and the ministry that I have received from the Lord Jesus to testify to the good news of God's grace. And now I know that none of you, among whom I have gone about preaching, proclaiming the kingdom, will ever see my face again. Therefore I declare to you this day that I am not responsible for the blood of any of you, for I did not shrink from declaring to you the whole purpose of God. Keep watch over yourselves and over all the flock, of which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers, to shepherd the church of God that he obtained with the blood of his own Son. I know that after I have gone, savage wolves will come in among you, not sparing the flock. Some, even from your own group, will come distorting the truth in order to entice the disciples to follow them. Therefore be alert, remembering that for 3 years I did not cease, night or day, to warn everyone with tears. And now I commend you to God and to the message of his grace, a message that is able to build you up and to give you the inheritance among all who are sanctified. I coveted no one's silver or gold or clothing. You know for yourselves that I worked with my own hands to support myself and my companions. In all this, I have given you an example that by such work we must support the weak, remembering the words of the Lord Jesus, for he himself said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." When he had finished speaking, he knelt down with them all and prayed. There was much weeping among them all. They embraced Paul and kissed him, grieving especially because of what he had said, that they would not see him again. Then they brought him to the ship. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned. I have called you by name, you are mine. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. You promised, O God, to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, God promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our ancestors, and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath God swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation, by the forgiveness of all their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be. forever.
Amen.
You promised, O God, to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us. Let us pray. Give thanks for the night which has passed, for rest, for recreation. Pray God's blessing upon all that lies before us this day. The people we will meet, the situations which we will encounter. Give thanks for the life of this Diocese of Southwark. We pray for the Deanery of Southwark and Newington, for Jonathan Sedgwick, the Area Dean, Alan Wilde, the Assistant Area Dean, and Keith Potter, the Lay Chair. Within the Word of Anglican Communion, we pray with and for the bishops, priests and people of the Diocese of Perth in Australia, Chhattisgarh in North India, and Chicago in the Episcopal Church of the United States. I pray for all who are involved in the emergency and rescue organizations and services, for London Fire and Rescue, London Air Ambulance, Metropolitan Police, London Ambulance Service, and the RNLI serving on the Thames. Lord, we beseech you mercifully to hear the prayers of your people who call upon you, and grant that they may both perceive and know what things they ought to do, and also may have grace and power faithfully to fulfil them. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God now and for ever. Amen. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so in faith and love we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil, and keep us in eternal life. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Mass according to the 1662 Book of Common Prayer will be celebrated at 10 a.m. All are welcome to attend, and that will also be live streamed.